I welcome you all for class 8 subject science. Today we are going to start with a new topic, that is crop production and management. So from where do we get energy? Yes, from the food we eat, right? The energy from the food is utilized by organism for carrying out their various body functions. All living beings need food for energy, right? Who will make the energy? You can see all this food give us energy for the body. Who is preparing the food now? Plants can make their food by themselves. Animals can make? No. Animals, including human beings, cannot make their own food. So we depend on the plants for our food. We get our food from plants or animals or both. In order to provide food for a large population, regular production, proper management and distribution is necessary. Before, in 10,000 BCE, people were nomadic. They were wandering in groups from place to place in search of food and shelter. They ate raw fruits and vegetables and started hunting animals for food. Later, they could cultivate land and produce rice, wheat and other food crops. Thus was born agriculture. Here you can see the people are doing agriculture. Now, what is a crop? When plants of the same kind are cultivated at one place on a large scale is called a crop. Crop of wheat means that all plants grown in a field are that of wheat. Example, there are different types of crops, cereals, vegetables, fruits. Now, these crops are classified into they can be classified on the basis of the season in which they grow. India is a vast country. It has climatic conditions like temperature, humidity and rainfall vary from one region to another. Accordingly, there is a rich variety of crops grown in the different parts of the country. Despite the diversity, two broad cropping patterns can be identified. These are the Kharif crop and the Rabi crop. The crops which are sown in the rainy seasons are called Kharif crop. The rainy season in India is generally from June to September. Which are the crops grown in the rainy season is paddy, maize, soya. Here you can see the Kharif crops. Those are the paddy, maize, soya bean and groundnut. Why do you think only these crops can grown in rainy season? Because paddy requires a lot of water. Therefore, it is grown only in the rainy season. These crops needs a lot of water. Therefore, it is grown in rainy season. The other type is the Rabi crops. The crops grown in winter season. It is from October to March are called Rabi crops. Example here is wheat, gram, pea, as you can see in the picture. These pulses and vegetables are grown during winter season. Some other also in the summer season. Which are those? Those are pulses and vegetables grown during summer at many places. Cultivation of crops involves several activities. What is the meaning of cultivation? Means growing crops. It involves several activities undertaken by farmers over a period of time. It is not in one day or two day. It takes some months to grow. You may find that these activities are similar to those carried out by a gardener. You have seen the gardener, a garden or a park where he plows. There are many steps. For example, here agriculture practices which are listed below are: first one is preparation of soil, second is sowing, adding manure and fertilizers, fourth irrigation, fifth protecting from weeds, sixth harvesting, seventh storage. These are the one after the other, that is what activities taken for the agriculture. In that, first we will learn, that is the preparation of soil. The preparation of soil is first step before growing a crop. What is this means? Means loosening of soil. One of the most important tasks in agriculture is to turn the soil and loosen it. This allows the roots to penetrate deep into the soil. It helps to breathe easily. What it is helping? The roots to breathe easily even they go deep into the soil. The loosened soil helps in the growth of earthworm. The loosened soil helps in the growth of earthworm and microbes present in the soil. These organisms are friends of the farmer since they further turn and loosen the soil and add humus to it. Soil contains minerals, water, air and some living organism. In addition, dead plants and animals get decomposed by soil organism. Various nutrients in the dead organism are released back into the soil. These nutrients are again absorbed by the plants. Since only a few centimeters of the top layer of the soil supports plant growth, turning and loosening of the soil brings the nutrient-rich soil to the top so that the plants can use these nutrients. What it means, the farmer has to first turn the soil, preparation of the soil. Here you can see the farmer is plowing the land. What is the meaning of plowing? The process of loosening and turning of the soil is called plowing or tilling. Here you can see it is how it can be done with a plow. You can see the plow there in the picture. It has a sharp blade, right? This is the sharp blade which you can see from that the mud is digged. Okay, this is the wooden strip that is known as plow shaft. And this is known as plowshare. Okay, there are two parts in this. From this, the farmer will plow. Plow are made up of wood and iron. If the soil is very dry, it may need watering before plowing. The plowed field may have big clumps of soil called crumbs. It is necessary to make these crumbs. Leveling the field is beneficial for sowing as well as for irrigation. Leveling of soil is done with the help of a leveler. The next step is that is sowing. Before sowing the seed, it is necessary to break soil clumps. What are the clumps which they have made the soil, right, to get better yield? Clumps are nothing but the hard soil. They have to break it. This is done with the help of various tools. The main tools used for this purpose are the plow. Just now I told you what is plow. The next here the picture is hoe. Hoe is a simple tool which is used for removing weeds and for loosening the soil. It has a long rod of wood or iron. A strong, broad and bent plate of iron is fixed to one of its end and works like a blade. It is pulled by animals. Nowadays, plowing is done by tractor-driven cultivator. The use of cultivator saves labor and time. This is a machine. You are familiar with the tractors, right? This plow and hoe is attached to the tractor so that the people cannot go and do it alone. So this tractor will help them. As you can see at the back of the tractor, there is a blade-like structures, right? This will help the farmer to loosen the soil. Sowing is an important part of crop production. We have now learned that before sowing, good quality, clean and healthy seeds of a good variety are selected. First they loosen the soil, then they have to select the top quality seeds. If the seeds are not good, then the crop is not good. So they have to select properly the seeds. Farmers prefer to use seeds which give high yield. High yield, if it is there, then only they can earn money, right? As you have seen your mother cleaning that is seeds. One day I saw my mother put some gram seeds in a vessel and pour some water on them. After a few minutes, some seeds started to float on the top. Why it will be floating? Yes, you can see in the picture, few seeds will bubble and come up. Why? Because the damaged seeds become hollow and are thus lighter, therefore they float on water. So this is a good method for separating good healthy seeds from the damaged one. Before sowing, one of the important tasks is to know about the tools used for sowing seeds. Here you can see that is the traditional tool. The tool used traditionally for sowing seed is shaped like a funnel. You can see the funnel there, the people are holding, right? The seeds are filled into the funnel, passed down through two or three pipes having sharp ends. These ends pierce into the soil and place seeds there. This is the traditional method. Nowadays, the seed drill is used for sowing with the help of tractors. This sows the seeds uniformly at equal distance. Means the distance of the seeds will be equal. At equal distance, and the depth also will be equal, so that each tree will get the space to grow. It ensures the seed get covered by the soil after sowing. Means directly with the tractor, they are sowing and they are closing the seeds. This protects the seeds from being eaten by birds. Sowing by using a seed drill saves time and labor. This will help what? Save the time also. Labor means the men working. The men which work is known as labor. This proper equal distance, what happens is it allows plants to get sufficient sunlight, nutrients and water from the soil. At times a few plants may have to remove to prevent overcrowding. Before, in the traditional method, they used to remove few seeds because it was overcrowding. Now in this method, seed drilling, automatically the seeds will be equally uniformly distributed. Therefore, there is no overcrowding of the seeds.